Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you about ovarian cyst imaging. Demnology, follicle, normal physiologic cyst less than 1 cm in diameter. Dominant follicle may measure up to 3 cm. Functional cyst can measure up to 3 to 10 cm. Corpus luteal cyst, dominant follicle after ovulation. Follicular cyst, normal mature follicle failed to involute. Hemorrhagic cyst, hemorrhage into functional cyst. Most common sign symptom usually is symptomatic. Pain is large or complicated by rupture, hemorrhage, or torsion. Corpus luteal cyst is more commonly symptomatic, even without significant hemorrhage. Other signs symptom, palpable mass, can present with compression of nearby structure, ureter or pelvic veins. Epidemiology. Neonate small cysts are present in up to 98% at birth, around 20% more than 1 cm. Premenarche cysts more than 1 cm in 2 to 5%. Postmenarche cysts are very common. Non-functional cysts and malignant ovarian neoplasm also occur at greater rate. Ultrasound is mainstay of ovarian imaging in limited circumstances, where imaginative round or ovoid structure is in border of ovary with no solid component. Sinewort, Latin, MM, Latin 6 mm, no internal supply, nodular fat, calcification or vascularity, increased heterogeneity with hemorrhage, internal reticulation or leg-like pattern, a clot mixed with tiny cystic space with its layering debris. Ultrasounds are two well-defined round or echoic structure obduting the uterus, both of which have imperceptible walls and increased through transmission consistent with symphysis. Contrast and CT obtained in the same patient also demonstrate typical characteristics of symphysis. The normal appearing left ovary lie directly adjacent to the large cyst on this image. Both cysts resolve by the time of follow-up ultrasound obtained several weeks later, consistent with follicular cysts. Colorectal ultrasound of an irregular cystic structure containing substantia. The ovary is surrounded by a large amount of heterogeneous echogenic material, which was mobile in real time. The finding indicative of a rupture hemorrhagic cyst. Contrast and CT in the same patient also demonstrate the left anexal cyst surrounded by a large volume of homoperitoneum that extend to the subdiaphragmatic region. T1 C plus FSMI in a 15 years old patient with a story of persistent complex right ovarian cyst, so a normal post contrast apparent of the right ovary with internal resolution of the cyst. A hemorrhagic has now developed in the left ovary T2-FSMR in a patient a few days later, so liquefying cyst contain endothelially and hemorrhage degrees dependently, in this case of a hemorrhage ovariosis. Treatment. Cyst less than 4 to 5 cm. I usually monitor with surveillance ultrasound. Surgery is considered in the lysis due to risk of torsion or neoplasm. Options include aspiration, fenestration, and resection. For resection, ovarian sparing approach is preferred if benign etiology suspect. Thank you.